Hey everybody, and Tony here with a review of Janacek's Katya Kabanova with conductor Thomas Gugais, which I saw last night at the Staatsoper unter den Linden. This marks the second time I saw this particular production, which I also saw 5 years ago with Deborah Pulaski as the Kabanicha, because Karita Mattila was going to sing the role of the Kabanicha after a series of Katyas that she has been doing decades ago. Now, I have been following Karita Mattila's career for decades, seeing that she used to specialize in a lot of the lyric soprano roles, such as Pamina and Dona Elvira, and then went on to singing more spinto soprano parts, such as Elsa von Brabant, Eva Pogna from the Meistersinger von Nürnberg, and Agatha from the Freischütz, and even to her ventures into the dramatic soprano repertoire with roles such as Tosca, the Fidelio Leonora, and Sieglinde, and nowadays she's singing a lot of the mezzo and contralto parts, including an upcoming Isolde that she's going to sing in 2020. Roles that she has sung as of recently are the likes of the Kostelnička, Madame de Croissy, and even an upcoming Ortrude. As I stated before, I have been following Karita Mattila's career for some decades already. I first saw her live when I was 15 years old, when she performed the role of the Fidelio Leonore at the Royal Opera House, and then I saw her 7 years later perform the role of Ariadne from Ariadne auf Naxos, and here she is attempting the dramatic mezzo parts and even some contralto parts. What I always loved about her voice is that it had that nice, rich, and creamy texture, which is well coordinated throughout the registers, and she is a dedicated singing actress. She managed to sell it as the Kabanicha, as she was able to inject her lasciviousness and her overall meanness to get this character down to a T. Vocally, she was still as impressive as ever, and her chest tones were still there, and they continued to be as fine and strong as ever. In fact, Karita Mattila's chest tones are definitely her greatest strong points, because she can do whatever she wants with them, and they can sound like full-sounding cellos every time she digs deep into them. So brava to Karita Mattila for doing such a fine job, and even though she was not like any true contralto akin to Res Fischer, Margarita Klose, Armida Persipetinella, Sona Cervena, Elvira Casazza, and many other great contraltos of the past, oh, unless I forget my personal favorite Kabanicha, Jane Henschel, she certainly did a fine job embodying this role, complete with such great musicianship and, of course, a well-coordinated register which she was able to conquer so well, and everything about Karita Mattila that made her stand out as an exceptional singing actress who goes all in for her roles. Returning as Katya, the title heroine, was Eva Maria Vesbruck. I definitely enjoy the dedication that she gives to this role that she has also been singing for decades. She managed to show a lot of vocal strength in this particular role, and even though there were some wobbles to be found here and there, those can be forgiven because of how much endurance and how much strength and how much she was able to persevere with this character that she has been singing all over the world. There's a certain steeliness to her voice that made her right above the orchestra so well, and she was able to continue to be a fine actress in this particular role. She was able to show a lot of depth of character and a lot of dimension as Katya Kabanova, a role that she's been singing for many years, and a role that she continues to find some very interesting and fascinating facets with. Overall, I can't go wrong with Eva Maria Vesbruck as a singing actress, as she does throw herself in, even with some warts found in her voice, such as a tremolo and a wobble. She still has an instrument that manages to show a lot of endurance and manages to show just how much of a diligent and an absolutely dedicated singing actress Eva Maria Vesbrück was. Striking again as Varvara was Anna Lapkowskaya, and her voice seemed to grow in a certain steeliness and richness compared to the last 5 years I saw her in this particular role. She definitely continued to make such a striking impression as Varvara, as she was able to make great use of that velvety and absolutely luscious mezzo-soprano voice of hers. I'm pretty sure that if she continues to develop her chest tones and keep using that chest voice to great advantage, I'm pretty sure that she can also take on roles such as Dalila, Amneris, Eboli, Venus, Kondri, and maybe even Adriano from Rienzi. The possibilities for this mezzo-soprano are absolutely endless. She continues to be such a charismatic figure on the stage, and for that, her voice does reflect the overall charisma and the overall beauty that she gives to each and every role she sings. Pablo Junca was a formidably voiced decoy. And what more can I say about this gentleman? His voice had that richness and that power and that stature that made him really wonderful as a basso cantante. He was able to sell it in this role and show just how much of a formidable singing actor he was. He definitely knew how to navigate this role with virility and a lot of awesome musicianship that I was practically on the edge of my seat. Artu Kataya was a decent kuligin. His voice does sound well focused, but I'm sure that it could be a whole lot richer and a whole lot fuller if he continues to sing in the pharynx, use chest tones, and have a much more well-coordinated voice. However, I still have to go out of my way and say that he was very dedicated and showed a lot of interest in portraying this small, yet rather interesting character. So when all is said and done, Artu Kataya still managed to do a really solid job embodying Kuligin. Simon O'Neill was an absolute joy to witness as Boris. He had that incision in his voice that made it ring throughout the theater, and he had an equally strong, tall, and formidable presence to boot. He practically made Florian Hoffmann's Kudryash look like a midget. That is just how much of a powerful presence he had on stage. It's as if Simon O'Neill is this huge grizzly bear and Florian Hoffmann's Kudryash is basically like this small jackal who is just shivering in the presence of this huge bear. That is just how much of a strong and formidable presence Simon O'Neill had. And that is also reflected on how well he was able to navigate those high notes, which he was able to sing with such ringing power. Sure, I would have loved to have a little bit more of a baritonal quality in any Heldentenor found in voices such as Ludwig Suthaus, Gunther Treptow, Ramon Vinay, and John Vickers. But when all is said and done, Simon O'Neill continues to go all in with every single role that he has, all thanks to his formidable stage presence and his equally fine and well-tuned Heldentenor voice, which showed a lot of endurance and a lot of perseverance when it comes to singing over an orchestra. Stefan Rugama continued to be as solid and as extremely dedicated as a singing actor in the role of Tichon. He may have the tendency to sing a lot in the mask, which results in his voice sounding nasal and rather unpleasant on some occasions, but his dedication as an overall singing actor cannot be questioned. Oh, sure, I do prefer a more steely and a more rich spinto slash Helden Tenor voice. Voices that come into my mind are the likes of Wolfgang Wingassen, Mario Del Monaco, Franco Corelli, and many other great dramatic tenors of the past. But when it comes to Stefan Rugema embodying Tichon, I still have to give him a lot of credit because he was able to bring in a lot of bile to this character, and you cannot go wrong with him in terms of how much dedication and how much hard work that he gives to each and every character he sings, whether they be leading men characters or supporting characters or even character parts. He definitely goes all in, and he's not going to back down anytime soon. Florian Hoffmann is rather decent as Kudryash. While I do like the fact that he has some chest tones, and while I do like the fact that he was able to bring in a lot of charisma to his character, there were times that the nasality of his voice can be rather off-putting. It sounds like everything that he sings is coming from either the nose or the mask, which is not really that great at all. I'm pretty sure that he can sing pharyngeally. If he can sing more on the pharynx, get rid of the nasality and the mask singing, I'm pretty sure that we would have a fine lyric tenor to call our own. Nonetheless, he still managed to embody the role of Kudryash with a lot of impetuousness and a lot of swagger to give this role a lot more life and a fair amount of charm. I shouldn't forget about the fine singing accomplished by Emma Sarkisian as a characterful Glasha, even though her voice did sound like it was past its prime, but still, she managed to be very into the drama, and she was still able to show a lot of guts, who may have sounded past her prime, but is still someone who does have a rather striking presence on stage. And Adriana Queiroz's full-sounding, full-bodied Veklusha, whose use of chest voice was absolutely phenomenal and well done. So overall, the singing was really good all around, especially if you had someone like Karita Mattila, who after singing a series of Katya Kabanovas embodied the role of the Kabanicha with lasciviousness, sliminess, and general meanness, but she was still so involving in this particular character. And I can never go wrong with Madame Mattila in terms of how she was able to throw herself into this part and find such rather interesting facets about the Kabanicha and make the role her own. The conducting done by Thomas Gugeis was wonderful all the way through. He whipped that orchestra into great shape, and he was able to pay close attention to each and every detail in the musical text. And of course, the chorus and orchestra of the Staatsoper Unter den Linden were phenomenal all the way through. So overall, with an exceptional performance accomplished by Karita Mattila, who managed to invest her energy, her overall dedication, and her overall passion as a singing actress to the role of Kabanicha, and even backed up by an equally fine cast, last night's performance of Katya Kabanova was quite the thrill ride. And for those of you who saw this particular production of Katya Kabanova at the Staatsoper Unter den Linden, what'd you think of it? Do you feel like Karita Mattila stole the show as the Kabanicha? Do you feel that Eva Maria Vesbruck was better in terms of her voice as Katya? Or do you feel like there was someone who stood out like a sore thumb? Comment below and let me know. Well, that's all for now. Be sure to tune in tomorrow for my review of Puccini's La Bohème, starring Attilio Glaser as Rodolfo. So until then, have a great day, everybody.